with unity, we can do great things, important things.
It seems from a distance that it's unhealable and like unfixable.
No one's gonna be able to heal it but our generation. I was there, I listened with my own ears. He told us to march peacefully. I don't think he incited the violence at all.
It's my belief that he directly incited the violence that resulted in the death of 5 people.
I definitely don't regret going. I will say I do regret the outcome. I think that any violence or any law breaking should be completely shamed and frowned upon. And you can see a clear divide from where the actual peaceful protesters stopped and the people that rushed the building that just wanted to cause violence entered and started rushing the Capitol building.
If these people were brown and black, I can guarantee you the crowd would not have made it as far into the Capitol as they did. And this is a direct result of white privilege in this country.
I don't think that anything should have happened in Black Lives Matter or on Capitol Hill with any type of killings, police brutality. But I think saying that it's because of their race, I think that's going to polarize the nation more.
We have to acknowledge right now that there is a divide in how people are treated based on their race when it comes to police officers.
I can't breathe! I can't breathe! I can't breathe!
The Trump era has been a difficult one to comprehend. It's been composed of so many young people and people of all ages turning against each other.
Being that it was so controversial, the Trump administration has gotten, I think, a lot of more average people into politics. It's beneficial to us that we see all these young people getting into politics. In order to unify the country, we kind of encourage more independent research rather than relying on mainstream media, whether you think it's against Democrats or Republicans.
This is what President Joe Biden has called upon us to unite, believe in what we can do together.
I live in a primarily white area, and I've seen the most damage done to communities of color when it comes to Fox News reporting things. At this time in the nation, where the nation is so incredibly polarized, it is of the utmost importance to not fan the flame.
I think it is very important that we stop looking at it as a war between the Republicans and the Democrats, and we do start communicating with each other.
We close the divide because we know to put our future first. We must first put our differences aside.
How do you think we should move forward as a nation to depolarize?
I think that it's really important young people understand the weight that's going to be on their shoulders in these upcoming years. You know, like, it's pretty obvious that America is very polarized right now, and no one's going to be able to heal it but our generation and the generations to come.
At our age, it's really easy to get tunnel vision. It's really easy to just, you know, separate ourselves and only talk to people who, you know, align with our specific political beliefs. There are clubs in my school that, you know, are more Republican. I think that we need to start communicating in between our clubs, because when you get into an echo chamber of your own beliefs, it's easy to just go on to life without having those interactions that, you know, are going to shift your political beliefs, are going to, you know, give you perspective.
Yeah, I agree. And I definitely think communication is probably the number one thing that needs to be achieved. And even right now, we could be debating the whole time, which we are. We obviously have common ground. But even if we were debating the whole time, that's still progressive discourse. And that is always going to be helpful. And whether or not we agreed on it, just speaking is definitely where we should start.
If you found that video interesting, there's a lot more to watch and talk about on our channel. So for all updates on everything BBC My World, subscribe here.